Hi class, welcome back to baking school. We are currently on lesson 10 of the baking fundamentals course, and today we are talking all about the function of eggs in baking. Now, as you know, eggs are an essential ingredient in traditional baking, and they are actually used in three different forms. So sometimes we use the entire egg in our baked good, sometimes just the egg yolk, and sometimes the egg white. And each of these forms has different functions, so let's dive into each. Okay, so let's talk about the anatomy of an egg. When you crack an egg open, you'll notice a few different parts. You'll notice that the outer part of the egg, which is the egg white, is pretty clear in color, and this contains mostly water and some protein. Now, the middle of the egg has the egg yolk in it, and that is pretty deep yellow in color, and this is mostly fat along with some water and also some protein. Now, you'll also notice some little white strands. Those are called the chalaza, and that is actually just holding the egg yolk in the middle of the egg. Now, for most baking purposes, this is completely fine to leave in, but some bakers do prefer to remove it for things like custard because it just ensures that you'll have a really smooth texture.
The best way to crack an egg is on a flat surface like your countertop, which will give you a nice clean break. You never want to crack your egg on the edge of a bowl, which is going to push shards of the eggshell right up into the egg.
Okay, so let's talk about egg sizing. Now, most standard baking recipes are going to call for large eggs. But you will notice that there are other sizes sold in your grocery store, and if you do buy farm fresh eggs, likely your carton is going to vary in sizes. Now, if you're just using one or two eggs in a recipe, using a medium egg in place of a large egg is probably not going to make that much of a difference. But this does start to matter more when your recipe does call for a large amount of eggs. You can see here when we've cracked a medium egg, a large egg, and an extra large egg that they do vary in volume somewhat. So if there is a large number of eggs in your recipe, this does start to matter more. So I've actually included a chart on the written part of this lesson for you to see what the conversions are for substituting eggs in recipes that do call for a large amount. Now, I should also note that when recipes do include the weight measurement for eggs, that is usually a pretty good indicator that it does matter for the egg measurements to be accurate. So I would definitely suggest weighing your eggs when a recipe does call for it. So as we think about the function of a whole egg in baking, it helps to think about all of the things that make up an egg. So an egg is made up of a lot of water along with some fat and protein. Now, the protein is going to begin coagulating as it heats up, and this adds a lot of strength and structure to our baked good. Now, the fat is going to add moisture and richness and some flavor, and the water is going to contribute to a lot of leavening. Now, if you remember from our lesson on leavening, steam is a great source of leavening, and as the water evaporates off, it's going to turn into steam, which is going to lift and rise our baked goods. Now I'm actually going to show you this video of a Dutch baby rising in the oven one more time, and this batter contains a lot of eggs and no other leavening agents. So everything that is making this Dutch baby rise is just the water evaporating off the eggs. So when you think about egg whites on their own in baking, they are usually called for when you are going to whip them into an egg white foam. Now, egg whites have the unique ability to hold a large amount of air after they are whipped. They can actually be whipped to 8 times their size. So an egg white foam is used really frequently to leaven cakes. It's also the thing that makes soufflés rise, and then egg white foam can actually be used all on its own as meringue. So egg yolks are part of the egg that contain all of the fat. So they are used in baking to add a lot of flavor, richness, and moisture. Now, egg yolks are also an excellent emulsifier, so they really help to bind and thicken. Egg yolks are a really key component in custards like pastry cream, and you'll see as you heat up a pastry cream, it really begins to thicken. And this is because the egg yolks are gelling as they are heated, which really helps thicken up the mixture. Now, I should also mention that egg yolks are really going to prevent egg whites from whipping to an egg foam. So you really need to be careful when separating the two.
The best way to separate an egg is to use your clean hands. Crack your egg into a bowl and then pick it up, allowing the white to drop back down into the bowl, leaving the yolk in your hand. Place the yolk into one bowl and the whites into a separate bowl. The reason I suggest using three bowls for this process is so that if you do happen to break a yolk while you are separating them, you are not risking contaminating your bowls of already separated egg whites.
Now, as a general rule of thumb, eggs should be at room temperature for baking. They are just more readily absorbed into batters and doughs when they are at room temperature, and egg whites beat up to their highest volume when they're at room temperature. So now that you understand all about how eggs work in baking, I want to give you your homework assignment. I'd love for you to try your hand at making a chiffon cake. And the reason I chose this cake is because you are going to use the entire egg in the recipe, but the egg yolks and the egg whites are going to get separated out during the mixing process. The egg whites will be whipped into an egg white meringue, and then that is going to get folded into the cake batter that does include the egg yolks. So it's really the best of both worlds. You get all of the richness and flavor from the egg yolks, but you're also going to get all of that lightness from the egg white meringue. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.